Earlier this year, Mercury launched a new Verado outboard engine like no other. It was an engine of big numbers, 600 horsepower, V12, and 7.6 litres of displacement. Now it's Australia's turn to see what it's about. Launched initially in the US, it's the most powerful normally aspirated outboard engine ever made. It's optimised for a new breed of ever larger 12 to 15 metre boats that need a turn of pace to get places fast, but with the convenience of lifting the engines out of the water. It also makes for super easy servicing. And Mercury hasn't just upped the horsepower with the V12 Verado. This engine introduces a few firsts for the marine industry, and two of them happened below the water, starting with the steering. Instead of the whole engine turning, like for a conventional outboard, just the V12's lower leg, sitting below the waterline, turns it up to 45 degrees. It allows the powerful V12 engines to be fixed solidly to the transom and packed more tightly together compared with conventional engines. Then there's how the V12 Verado transfers all that horsepower to the water. This engine features a duoprop setup, meaning it's got two propellers, one with four blades and the other one with three. But this engine also features another industry first, a two-speed transmission that helps it with performance and efficiency. First gear gets the boat up onto the plane, and then second gear kicks in to give solid economical cruising. But enough sitting here talking about how it goes, let's see what this Verado can do. So just cruising along at low speed, this boat is feeling great. I mean, the steering, the new electric hydraulic steering is just direct. You can feel everything that's happening behind you. The throttle too, it's an electronic throttle now, so it's quite sensitive, but geez, it responds so quickly to what you're doing. Now, the other feature that we have introduced on this boat is a quick steer function. There's a button here that you push. It switches the wheel into a special mode where you only need to do a quarter turn lock to lock, which is great for low speed maneuvering.
Helping us control all this performance is Mercury's new next-gen digital throttle and shift controller, introduced at the same time as the new V12 Verado.
This is Mercury's new digital throttle control, and there's a couple of things here that we've noticed straight away that we're instantly drawn to. One is the fact that we've now got this neutral light here that tells us when the gearbox is in neutral. You don't have to guess. There's also a lock that stops you accidentally knocking the throttle into gear. Something else we've seen is active trim, which is standard on this engine. So basically the boat takes care of all the needs for trimming by itself. But enough of tooling around. I mean, we've got 600 horsepower at our disposal. Let's open the throttle and see what it's got.
Hole shot performance, leaping from a standing start to up on the plane, happens quickly, and the step from first to second gear as the V12 Verado cuts from performance focus to free running is imperceptible. Roll on the throttle and this engine will easily push this lightweight rib along. But while it's fun to see how fast you can push this V12 engine, it's also about efficiency at cruising speeds. Mercury claims a single 600 horsepower engine can deliver up to 20% in fuel savings.
And from here, that looks about right. I mean, here we are, we're sitting on 3,400 RPM. We're doing 50 kilometres an hour over the water, and we're burning about 54 litres an hour, which is quite economical. Behind us, the electronic gimmickry in that engine is actually tuning the boat as we go to keep it in its most economical mode.
And that's what this engine is about, fast, economical cruising. But despite its sophistication, Mercury has also worked hard to minimise the amount of servicing needed to keep this outboard engine on the water.
Now, the servicing for this engine is every 200 hours, and it's just a simple matter of opening that top cowling and all the service points are directly below it. In fact, you only need to pull this boat out of the water and access the lower cowling every 1,000 hours.
There's also the simplicity of a V12 compared with a generation of highly strung big block V8s. These V8s use forced induction to achieve a similar level of performance to the V12 Verado, but their makers didn't think outside the box like Mercury has. While it is setting benchmarks in the outboard engine world, Mercury's new 600 horsepower outboard engine is also sporting a new generation of boats that use it. Our test today is for a single engine application, which is why it's hooked up to a lightweight rib. It's not much effort for the V12 to pop this Gemini up onto the plane. But the reality is that if you have a heavier fiberglass boat, you're going to need at least a pair of these bad boys just to get it up onto the plane.
Now, the idea behind these Mercury engines was that it was to replace multiple engines. Like, you could have a boat with four engines on the back of it, and instead all you need is two of these. Of course, having a single engine on a boat is a bit unusual, but it suits beamy boats like this rib. Now, we've heard of some Australian manufacturers that have thought about introducing this engine to Australia. Nothing yet, but we hear there's something in the pipeline.
The new Mercury V12 is a huge power flex in an age where particularly the European recreational boating industry is looking to green up its image. There is obviously still appetite for high performance boats that can run hard and fast, and that's where this engine shines. If only it sounded like a V12 though, this thing is whisper quiet all through the rev range from idle to wide open throttle.
At around $120,000, and that doesn't include the cost of fitting it, this is an expensive option, not to mention the fact that you need to buy the boat to put it on. But for those who can afford it, that tingle you get up your spine every time you open the throttle, it'll be worth it.